Abby, welcome to the Kelku Review Show. Today we're joined by Joe.
Hello.
We are going to be reviewing extreme sports cameras. Good. Red, awesome, totally wicked.
I can't even tell you how much we had to pay her to do that.
Yeah.
No, anyway. So, yeah. Shall I get going?
Do it.
Okay, first one we're going to look at is the GoPro Hero, and this is basically the top of the range. So this is kind of ideal for anyone that's doing anything extreme, so skiing, anything even more extreme than that, anything underwater. It has functions and features for all needs. It's about 300 quid just for the main camera section, and then there's this, which is a viewfinder, which sits on the back, and that costs about another £80. So the two are sold separately, but there's a reason why that is. We can work it out, but I'm sure there is. They snap together, and basically, it allows you to view what you're filming.
Is so, that just for the setup, so you can set it up?
Exactly, yeah. So, obviously, you can't really view while you have it strapped to your face.
Shall I strap
Speaking
this to
of
my
which,
face?
Yeah,
let's strap it on. My hair, okay?
Don't touch me.
Okay. Oh, it's really big. Let's pretend that it's not falling off. I'll hold it, it's fine. I'm working it.
Yeah.
I'm really into this, yeah. Don't punch me in the face by accident.
Oh, I can't even get this open. There we go. So that, basically, that bit fits in there, like so. And then...
Getting concussion.
It's a bit tricky. Should have practiced this, shouldn't we?
Yeah, maybe should have done it off my head.
There you go.
Okay.
And then you can tighten that up if you want, but up to you.
But you haven't got the viewfinder on it.
Yeah, so you basically, you don't do that. You get a friend to set it up for you, or set it up when it's not on your head. And then there you go.
Can
so
I just say, this is really heavy.
Is it, do you think?
Whoa, yeah. Yeah, I feel like, I literally feel like I'm just gonna fall on my face.
Yeah, it is quite heavy, isn't it?
Yeah.
I think if you're genuine extreme though, you wouldn't really say things like that, would you? You just kind of deal with it. Anyway, right, so it's got only two buttons, which is good for when it's actually on top of your head because you can't be faffing around with menus and things. But to set it up, it is a bit of a pain, isn't it? We have to press about 8 different combinations in order to get it to do what you want.
Yeah.
But you do that once a day, basically. So once you're set up, you're ready. It's on top of your head, press.
And these, like, you've got one for the head, but can you get them?
Yeah, you can buy things to go on your chest and you can strap it to whatever you want, basically.
And your arm?
Yeah, I think they've got a whole range of accessories.
Okay, how many, what's the stats on it?
Quality-wise, it's really good. It's basically, as I said at the beginning, it's basically the top of the range camera for the extreme sports market. And it will do 1080p filming when you're filming at normal speed. And if you want to go to 50 frames per second slow motion, it'll basically give you 720p. So it's very, very, very good quality. And it costs 300 quid, but you know, a camera that gives you that high definition generally is a lot more expensive than that. So I think this is a pretty good price.
Yeah.
For the quality and the fact it's got so many
different...
It's
a bit fiddly, like there's a big instruction manual, like the yellow pages.
It's
quite a lot of work.
Yeah, I think it's worth it though.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you want to take that back?